Andrew Charlton, Labor MP, member for Parramatta, joins me, and Liberal MP Zoe McKenzie, the member for Flinders. Zoe, this is one very big target. We've spoken a lot about small target oppositions. Mr. Dutton's certainly not that. He's rolled the dice here.
No, he's showing enormous courage, conviction and a good vision for this country. You know, I remember serving in the Howard Costello era, and we took GST to the people, we took it to an election, we stood by our convictions, we said it was the right thing for the country. They were long, detailed debates we had with the people of Australia, and that is exactly what's proposed here. At least a consultation period of 2.5 years, but obviously already a very vibrant debate about having all eggs on the table in terms of the energy market going forward.
Yeah, Andrew Charlton, why not have everything on the table? What's the problem with that? Just lift the ban at least.
Well, Kieran, I think there are three things in Peter Dutton's nuclear proposal that are going to concern a lot of Australians. The first one is cost. Each of these reactors costs $16 billion. Peter Dutton is proposing to build 7 of them. That is $112 billion. That is $8,000 per working Australian that it will cost each Australian to build these reactors. The second one is time. Australians need support with their energy bills now. The average energy bill in Parramatta is nearly $500 per quarter. People don't want to wait 10 years or 15 years for some energy price relief. They need it now. And the third problem is climate change. This is a proposal to maintain coal for 15 years plus. So when Australians learn that this proposal is going to cost them a lot, it's going to take an enormous amount of time, and it's going to be bad for the environment, they're going to be pretty disappointed with Peter Dutton.
Zoe, on each of those points, can you respond?
Look, can I say in terms of the environment, I'll start where Andrew left off. We have to remember what impact the current plan is going to have on the Australian environment. 22,000 solar panels are meant to be going up every day. 40 new wind turbines every month to 2030. 28,000 kilometres of new poles and wires encircling the nation. So we have to think about what the existing plan, and that's if everything goes right. Let me give you a micro example of how things are not going right. In my own electorate of Flinders, we are meant to be having a renewable energy terminal erected in a UNESCO biosphere of Westernport, an enormous thing, right, that would dwarf the MCG were it to be erected. Tanya Plibersek cancelled that plan, didn't tell her friends in Spring Street that that's what she was going to do. The energy terminal is now in chaos. It was meant to be sending wind turbines out to the Gippsland Seas, where we also know that people don't want to see them. If there was anything other than pure fantasy in the existing plan, maybe Labor would have a leg to stand on, but it does not, thus returning us to an all options on the table point of view, including baseload gas in addition to nuclear, to keep meeting the needs in an affordable way for Australian households and Australian businesses.